All right, now, once again.
I'm Tom Dacey.
And I'm Ed McCarver.
Welcome to Trick or Treat TV.
WPAA Trick or Treat TV for this Saturday night, October 31st, our annual Trick or Treat, where we invite all the trick or treaters that may want to come down here to 28 South Orchard Street to come on and be on the air, show us your costumes, and I think they're giving out some treats in front of the studio. I think I understand Freeman's down there.
Freeman's down there, yep.
And other guests, you'll be able to see the two murals that are down there. The tiger that's permanently on the side of the wall, and the other mural that I saw when we were coming in, all set to be displayed, and you could enjoy the mural and also come up here and talk to us here.
And I believe they're still accepting suggestions to name the tiger.
Oh, is that? Oh, okay. Okay, yes. Very good.
Until Election Day.
Very good. Until Election Day, which will be here this Tuesday. So just a few short days remaining. Not only cast your ballot for whatever candidate you want, but cast your ballot to name the tiger. I did see that Tony was not accepted. I think I saw that on Facebook, which is funny. There is a shot of the, and I'm assuming this is going out over the air. This is a shot of our grounds here at 28 South Orchard Street, and you see some trick or treaters that down there. There is our friend Kurt. So yep, and there are some trick or treaters, so they can come get treats, and then also come up and see us here upstairs at WPAA. So
I like your attire tonight, Ed.
Yeah, I kind of like this. I wasn't sure if this would read well, but this is I'm going for the beanie look.
I don't know. I don't think my hat's going to stay on. I keep losing my hat here.
We hope that hat stays on, that the head doesn't fall off whenever the hat goes. And, of course, you have your Freeman.
Yes, I'm modeling the Freeman attire
Penny
this
Quinn,
evening.
So, which is
anybody can be Freeman.
Yes, this is true. And this is WPAA. Of course, the longtime motto was your town, your station, and it can be, you know, this station is here for you, not just the two ghouls you see on your screen right now, but you can come up and make use of the fine facilities here at WPAA. Again, we are here for our annual Halloween special, Tom Dacey and Ed McCarver. Am I talking too much?
Trick or Treat TV.
Yep, Trick or Treat TV. You can come up and not only get some
treats, yep. And then they can come upstairs to the studio.
Come up here and say hello. Maybe
say hello.
Yep. Maybe you have someone watching TV that you're not able to get to their house or not able to see you in this town. I know with Frontier TV, with the old U-verse, you know, you can get public access from other towns. And if you want to alert somebody that you're coming down here to the studio, that you'll be on TV. We're going to be here for the next hour or so, I understand. So we may be here for a while, but who knows? But who knows? It's live TV. It's Halloween. You never know what trick-or-treats will happen during the early evening, but it'll be fun no matter what happens.
What is your favorite trick-or-treat candy?
I'll tell you, I am partial to Peter Paul Mounds.
Are you really? Because
yep.
I just heard the poll that was out the other day, and the top was Reese's Peanut Butter Cups.
Actually, it's funny you should say
that
here.
That is one of my favorites.
Yeah, as part of my list of items to pat about, was the most popular candy by state. It actually was something I originally heard on Chaz and AJ this week on WPLR. And now, actually, we have this just in. Ed, please adjust your hat. So, actually, it's just we want to remind viewers that you could watch this program and other programs on live HD. If you go to, and correct me if I'm wrong here, Alan, go to WPAA.TV,
mm-hmm.
Click Watch TV, And then click the click here place, and you will get this new feature, live HD.
And I have to tell you, I watched it myself the other night for the Gospel Jubilee.
Which is seen here Monday nights, I think, at 7:30? Is that
yes,
is that when they're on here?
Let me tell you, the quality is phenomenal.
Really? Nice. Nice. So once again, that's a Watch Live HD. Go to WPAA.TV, click Watch TV, click the Click Here logo, and you'll get that new feature. So so very good. So public access and WPAA is come a long way since we first started.
Many moons ago.
Yeah, what, 20 years for you? 94 you started?
Yeah, 94.
Yep,
so.
Yep. And I started with John years. Back in 1998. So it's been seems like yesterday, but it's been a long road. And then some of the changes in technologies just.
It doesn't seem possible that it's been that long.
Just amazing. You were talking about Reese's peanut butter cups being your favorite Halloween treat, and. We talked about the, this is something that I originally heard on a radio program, Chaz and AJ, earlier this week, the most popular candy by state. And for Connecticut, it was Reese's Peanut Butter Cups.
Way to go.
I am not sure why. They are delicious, you know. I'm a Mounds guy myself, but Connecticut has Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. And I think, what is our neighbor to the north? Massachusetts has Starburst.
Oh, wow. I would not have guessed there. Starburst. But yeah. I did hear on the report that I heard that Reese's was followed up by Kit Kat and Butterfinger.
Butterfinger I show here as the favorite if you were trick-or-treating in the state of Idaho. You would go for Butterfingers. And where else here? North Carolina.
We know it's Bart Simpson's favorite.
Yes, North Carolina has Butterfingers, and I think that is it. We mentioned Massachusetts being Starburst is their number one candy. And this was the information for this comes from a website called Influenstar, which is a survey they did. They surveyed over 40,000 people across the nation and recorded which Halloween treat each state prefers. And we have a number of these. We'll go over some of them later. Just Rhode Island, though. Rhode Island is like Connecticut. They also like Reese's peanut butter cups. So it's kind of interesting. So once again, Tommy, we're here at, for you and I, is our second annual Halloween Trick or Treat TV here at WPAA.
Waiting to see what the most popular costume is this year.
Yeah, I have a list here that we can go through later. I know last year, I guess it was, is it Elsa from Frozen?
Yeah, we had quite a few Elsas last night.
Yeah,
Last year. Other princesses as well.
Yep. They were.
That always seemed to be a popular.
Yeah, the Disney Disney Frozen, and I have a list of the top 20 costumes this year, and a lot of them are.
Excuse me, Ed, but I think I'm going to take my hat off.
Oh, okay. Yep.
It's not staying on.
Yeah,
so.
Right. But there are 20 costumes, and we'll go over them later on. But a lot of them are, as you would expect, are influenced by movies, you know. I've never seen Frozen.
I have.
Yeah. Is it good?
It was a good movie. Yeah. I enjoyed it.
So, but another one of Disney's favorite movies. I'm trying to think the last Disney movie I saw. God, it probably was Beauty and the Beast. So it's been a while. So we will be here at least until the top of the hour, and maybe longer. And I remember when I was a kid, I couldn't wait for it to get dark. Mm. You know, I wanted to go out, and I'm sure you were the same way.
Yeah, and of course, this time of year, you know, with the clocks changing tonight.
Yep.
You know, it tends to get dark by 4:30.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I can remember, you know, always going on around 4:30, 5 o'clock. You know, this way we get out and get home early before the real mad rush.
Yeah. Yeah, it'll be crazy tonight, I'm sure, with between 8 and 9 o'clock when maybe some of the older kids go out. And I'm wondering, because it's a Saturday night, you know, there's no school, there's no work the next day, I wonder if maybe some of the trick-or-treaters will be out a little bit longer than
that was one of my thoughts earlier, too. Yeah. Like you said, this year it falls on a Saturday, so they don't have to worry about going to school in the morning. And
yep. So if they want to trick-or-treat them, maybe eat a lot of the candy when they get home, so they'll be sugared up, so they'll be up all night anyway here. And I've just been told by a member of our crack staff that, I don't know if he knows this by experience, but bars are open till 2 a.m.
Yes, yes.
So,
and a lot of holiday festivities going on tonight at different establishments.
I can imagine, so...
I know where you and I will be tonight after this. Be watching your Metropolitan.
Yes, I will be watching the New York Mets, and I hope that Steven Matz comes through and gets a victory for our Mets. I must confess, I only watched about 2 or 3 innings last night, and the Mets were down 4-3, and I just was I can't watch it, so. So I went to bed. I woke up at 2 o'clock, and then I checked at 2 o'clock and saw that they had won.
So I was out myself last night. So when I got home, I saw that the Mets were down, and I was like, "Oh my God, they're coming back!"
Yeah, they got to Matt Harvey the first. Well, didn't really get to him. That first game was a classic. They got to the reliever Familia when they tied the game in the bottom of the ninth. And then, of course, it went 5 more innings. It went 14 innings, and then Kansas City won. And then the second game, on Wednesday, they got to Jacob DeGrom, who I guess they said might have been a little tired going into this game anyway, and just killed him.
But what a marathon game that was the other night! I watched that. I watched that whole game.
5.5 hours, I think it was. Yeah.
First, you had the incident with. Their truck.
I had heard that Fox was off the air for a while.
Yeah, so they went over to the international feed.
Yeah, and how was that?
It was pretty wild because the poor guys in the Fox studio had no clue what was going on.
Uh-huh.
They were totally clueless. And at one point they're like, "Are we going back to Kansas City now?" And they thought they were going back to Joe Buck.
Yeah,
they went to the international feed.
Oh, and who were the international announcers? Was it not a name we would know?
I can't recall offhand.
Okay, but were they good? They knew the sport.
Yeah, they explained what was going on and why they had to switch over.
Huh. Interesting.
But I felt bad for the fans in the stands because they had no idea why the game was being delayed.
And I heard, of course, I get all my sports information from Mike Francesa from WFAN, and they were saying that Mike was saying that you know, Terry Collins, the manager of the Mets, was, you know, screaming, you know, "Let's play this game," because they don't want Matt Harvey or any of the other players to kind of get tight and get cold and not be as effective. They were all warmed up, they were ready to play, and then all of a sudden they weren't able to have the game delayed because of this malfunction with Fox Network here. So
it's going to be a long night, gentlemen.
Well,
you haven't seen a ghoul or a goblin within.
Really?
This
well,
is what we are giving out, just so that you.
Oh, all right.
Can tell
all first. Right.
And have to make a mess.
Let's see. All right.
Well,
I thought I hear some footsteps up here. Do we have our first trick-or-treaters here? Okay, do you want to get welcome? Come on and sit down. You look well dressed for the occasion. Now, I'm going to take my microphone over here just so the mic will pick you up. If you want to start the cat character, your name?
Olivia Masio.
Olivia, can you pick that up okay, Alan? Okay, your name once again?
Olivia Masio.
Masio. And your name, young man?
Lonnie Lee.
Lonnie
Hello,
Lee.
Lonnie. I recognize Lonnie.
I'm a cat, and woman, well, kind of, maybe Batman slash Cat.
Catwoman from the old Batman series.
Yeah.
Now, not Julie Newmar, right?
No.
No, all right.
I recognize Lonnie from his greeting he did.
Oh, yeah. And I'm a fisherman.
You are. I tell you, I love the hat. So that's very good. Now, you've just gone out trick-or-treating now? You've just started?
Yeah. We're going somewhere, but we stopped by before.
Oh, okay. Okay. Now, I know the night is relatively young, but and you are our first trick-or-treaters, but are there a lot of ghouls and goblins?
I saw a couple. I saw a ghost and a zombie.
A ghost and a zombie? Oh, okay. Okay, and we're going to switch microphones here. Let me just see if I can take this here. And if you want to take this microphone, and if you could say testing 1, 2, check, check, just to make sure we're okay.
Testing 1, 2, check, check.
So we're waiting for the thumbs up here if you want to try it one more time.
Testing 2, 1, testing, check, check.
Now what? I'll grab this, and when we get the word that stand up, that handheld mic is working, we'll do that. Thank you for giving us a couple of minutes, and I hope you enjoy some of this healthy candy. Why did you pick a fisherman?
Well, I picked a fisherman because before I liked to fish and stuff like that, and I didn't get a costume yet until last minute. And the stores were probably closed, so I just found stuff around my house, and it turned out to work out.
Okay.
I mean, it worked out.
You look very, very warm, and it's a very cool evening out there.
I was going to say, a nice warm costume on a cool evening tonight.
It's very cold.
And what made you decide to be a feline tonight?
Well, that I really like cats, and...
And you like Batman
yeah.
and the
yeah, I like and, cats, and the movie. Batman and Catman, I mean Catwoman. So this is why I chose, cause.
Okay. Well, it's very good. One more for me, if I may. The fact that Halloween is on a Saturday night this year, no school tomorrow.
No school Monday and Tuesday also. There's no school Monday and Tuesday. Monday, I'm pretty sure, is Election Day, and Tuesday...
Tuesday's Election Day.
Tuesday's Election Day, and I think we have Monday off because teachers have meetings and stuff like that.
Oh, okay.
Conferences.
So you could go on a Halloween bender for 4 days.
There you go.
You can get as much sugar as you want. So.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
What is your favorite Halloween candy?
My favorite... I know what hers is. Reese's, obviously.
Oh, see, another vote for Reese's, Ed. There you go.
Reese's is making it tonight.
Well, I mean, it's hard to choose, but if I had to choose, I would probably choose maybe a Milky Way or something like that.
Milky Way? Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Is there anybody that may be watching that you want to say Happy Halloween to or hello?
Hi, people. Hi.
No one in particular? And, no one that could watch, if they have a computer, they could watch live HD. If they go to WPAA.TV, click Watch TV, and click here, and you'll see live HTV. So not only do you need a television set, you could also see it on the computer as well. You could see this idiot with the beanie hat that's on the screen right now. So... Well, we want to thank you for coming up.
Yeah.
We hope we didn't cut into your prime trick-or-treating time.
No, we'll be here later.
Okay.
Thank
and,
you.
And if you see other ghosts and goblins,
tell them to come on up and say
come
hello.
Back,
so. Okay. Bye.
Thank you.
Olivia, you're back. You got it?
Well, that was very nice.
Lonnie and Olivia.
Lonnie and Olivia, a fisherman and a
catwoman.
Respectively. And I want to thank Susan for bringing the water,
You can
too.
Do just what Lonnie and Olivia did if you're in the area here at 28 South Orchard Street. Come on up and say hello.
Yep, we will be here for a while. Come on up, say hello. Maybe you have someone at home that can't get out. You tell them to tune in on Channel 18 or go to WPAA.TV on the internet, and they'll be able to see them that way.
Channel
99
Frontier.
Channel 99. I should know that too. I have Frontier. Channel 99 on Frontier. Hopefully, my bride is watching as she's giving out candy at the.
I don't know. She sees you enough, doesn't she?
Yes. You know, she was very happy that when the Patriots not only beat my team, the Jets, last Sunday, but then 4 days later, the following Thursday, beat your team.
I don't want to talk about that.
So, but I'm sure Maureen is one happy woman because, you know, her team beat up our team.
They can't be stopped.
No. I hate to say it, and Bill Belichick and Tom Brady, it's like the perfect storm up in New England. And
we know our good friend John Z is pretty happy.
Yes. John Z, who I see is vacationing in Facebook, or just came back from vacation.
He just came back.
Yeah, but, I'm sure he's happy that his team is winning. He reminds me every once in a while that Brady is a lot better than my beloved Jets, but... Anyway, I digress here. We're back here at WPAA Trick or Treat TV.
Yes, Trick or Treat TV is. We're looking outside at our parking lot. I don't see any trick or treaters out there at this moment.
No, it looks vacant for the moment, but you can get up there and gank some of that candy that's up there, and then come up here and say hello to us here on the second floor at the studio at 28 South Orchard Street. Of course, we're celebrating Halloween, also known as All Hallows' Eve, All Saints' Eve. It is celebrated not only in this country, Tom, but also in the United Kingdom, Ireland, and Canada. Now, the origin of Halloween dates back to the ancient Celtic festival of Samhain. The Celts, who lived 2,000 years ago in the area that is now Ireland, the United Kingdom, and northern France, celebrated their new year on November 1st. Now, Celts believe that on the night before the new year, the boundary between the worlds of the living and the dead became blurred. Hmm. And I think anybody that has seen our program probably thinks the same thing, that the boundary between the living and the dead has become blurred.
I kind of like this Freeman mask.
Do you really? So it looks good. It looks good. Maybe... No, I can't say it. So. Maybe if you want to go ahead and pull a job later this year, no one would recognize you. But no, maybe I should refrain from saying that.
Just kidding, everyone. I would never do that.
So these are some of the treats that we're giving out here at the studio.
Smart food, white cheddar.
Smart food, white cheddar. I don't know if it reads... It probably reads a little bit.
And also Doritos.
Doritos, which are very, very famous. Yeah, there's a nice shot. Thank you, Alan. So, shot of the Doritos, all healthy and good for you, and kind of a fun food to eat. I don't remember Doritos or smart food
when
I was trick or treating.
No.
We used to get a lot of Hershey's, a lot of candy bars.
I do remember getting potato chips back then.
Yep.
But, you know, none of the brands that are around today.
Yeah, we used to get them too. Do they still do UNICEF, the United Nations?
I have not seen any ads for that.
When I was a kid, that was
yeah.
Big.
Like the last year or so. I mean, they used to be big on TV with the ads in past
yep.
years.
Trick or treat for UNICEF. Used to see it all the time.
Over the last year or so, I have not seen
yeah,
any.
Yeah, I haven't either. And I want to, United Nations International Children's Emergency Fund, I think is what it stands for.
I believe that's what it is, yeah.
But I think it's still going on. But I remember Halloween was like their Super Bowl. They would, you know, advertise all over the place. And the reason I say that is we had a guy in our neighborhood when I was a kid that wouldn't give you candy unless you were collecting for UNICEF.
Wow,
he was pretty
something.
Adamant about it. So needless to say, we on mischief night we took care of him. So, but that was back 40 years
though,
ago.
Last night was pretty quiet compared to past years for mischief night.
Yeah, we didn't see anything up where Maureen and I live up in Ridgeland. I mean. I don't know if they still soap windows, but I used to, once in a while, I used to see, you know, the toilet paper
in the trees.
In the trees. I didn't see any of that.
No, I didn't see any last night either, so.
So maybe, yeah, it was, which maybe is a good thing. So,
I mean, because I was out last night, and, you know, I expected to see, you know, people running out and about on my way home, but.
I think the last time I was victimized by Mischief Night, I want to say it was about 15 years ago when somebody egged my car. Mm. But I think that was it. I don't know if they don't do it anymore or it's just which is good if it's not in vogue anymore. But
we had instances in last year and the year before where a few of my neighbors' cars were egged.
Oh, really?
But like I said, I didn't see anything last night.
Yeah, they call it Mischief Night, and I'm sure that they step up patrols and things like that, as they will tonight too, looking out for the trick or treaters, the young trick or treaters, and I'm sure maybe the not so young trick or treaters, which I'm sure will be out in force again, particularly because it's a Saturday night. And did you hear what was the fisherman's name?
That was Lonnie.
Lonnie saying, you know, he not only has tomorrow off, he has Monday and Tuesday, so we could go on a 4-day sugar binge. So he's
I did hear that the schools were closed Monday and Tuesday, and I do believe it's a teachers' conference on Monday, and of course Tuesday being election day
on Tuesday, which is a big day, and I did not realize that they were closed on Monday for teachers, but a nice 4-day break, and it's kind of nice that Halloween. Fits right in there. Again, we're here with the WPAA Trick or Treat TV here at 28 South Orchard Street. Tommy and I here for our second year. I'm not sure how many years the station's been doing it, but it's our second year. I know they did it for a couple times.
I think
before.
It's at least three or four, right, Alan?
It's been
three.
Oh, 3 years. Okay.
Three.
Okay. So this is a. Yeah, it's kind of a fun tradition, and of course anything with live TV is a riot.
The year before we did it, it was Mike Cuomo and Rich Mavroganis.
I do remember that. Yes, I think, and which makes me want to say that I think Halloween was on a Wednesday night because I think that was Mike's slot back in.
I believe so.
Back in the old days, boy, that was 3 years ago.
Yeah.
Wow, that was a.
All I remember is Rich's head floating in the air, remember?
I do remember that, yeah. Yeah, that was funny. That was funny. That was the
floating head.
That was a...
Goblin in sight, not Center Street's quiet, everything's quiet.
Unusual well, for the quiet. Type of weather we have tonight.
Yeah, yeah. I was surprised unless they're going to get a late start or maybe they're nervous about the Mets, but I'm not sure what... What else is going on? But
I don't know. I know it was all over social media because I
awesome.
You said, "Oh no, there's a shot there." All right, and well, I see
some. I guess
some,
we're getting some come up now.
Yes, I see one sprinting in. So that looks good. That's a shot of the front of our studio here at 28 South Orchard Street. I see a canine. Maybe they'd like to come up for a treat. But
I don't think we have any dog treats, though.
No. Unfortunately, all right. There are some kids there. It looked like they were headed back out, but maybe they. Okay, now they're getting the word if they want to come up. But
I don't think.
It looks like they're declining the offer for the for the moment here. No, come on up. Well, I don't know if I saw me.
Maybe they're scared of us.
Yeah. Probably not a bad idea.
Oh, look, and there's the HD.
Oh, okay. There's a nice shot from HD, which you could watch by going to WPAA.TV, click Watch TV, click on Click Here, and you'll be connected to that new feature. That is a nice looking feature here. So. Very, very nice. All this part of the Watch TV, and you can see Alan is showing you just how exactly to go through that. That is the Watch TV.
Yeah, and of course, you have all our on-demand programs in there.
Yep, I see Michael Berdinsky's picture over in the right.
Center Michael, ring.
Yep, Center Ring, Midlife Matters with Georgianne is here. It's good to have Mike back, especially now with this political season heating up and with the election.
This is the hot political season.
Yep.
So.
Yep, between Mike and Ralph, Ralph Tomaselli, who is Mike's co-host. It's a good show. It's seen, what's the thing? If it's 9 at night, it must be Mike, I think, is the promo for it. So.
Citizen Mike.
Oh, Citizen Mike, yes. Yeah. Yes, Citizen Mike. If it's 9 at night, it's Citizen Mike. Yep. Yes, now I remember that. So.
I still like the beginning of that.
Yep.
The opening.
That actually, I think, did Eric
Our
shot
good
that,
friend,
didn't,
yeah. Eric Schrader.
Eric Schrader, who is now making a very good living out on the West Coast.
Yes, matter of fact, he liked our video.
Oh, did he?
Yeah,
did he?
Of the Halloween greeting.
Good, good. He had a couple of posts on Facebook, getting into the spirit of the season, dressed as a ghoul and walking down the streets of Hollywood. But he's an amazing talent, and I always say that the East Coast loss is the West Coast gain.
Yeah, absolutely.
With Eric Schrader. Mm-hmm. So, but anyway, we are here. Trick or Treat TV for WPAA. We're here on Saturday night, October 31st, All Hallows Eve. We invite anybody trick or treating in the area to stop by, get some delicious and healthy treats here, and come up and say hello to us. Maybe sit on the couch and have a couple words with us here. Maybe say hello to someone or just express anything about Halloween and tell us what the in costumes are. And we're going to be here for a while. I'm not sure how long we'll be here, but I told Maureen if I'm not home by 2 a.m. to set the clocks back anyway in case we're still here.
Mine are already done.
Good, good. All right, there's a shot of our very quiet outside street scene now.
I'm amazed.
But maybe we'll get more.
I'm amazed because last year we had quite a few last year, and if I remember correctly, I don't think the weather was as nice last year.
I thought it was a little colder. It was also a weeknight.
Yeah.
So, I don't know if there's... Alan's asking us if it was when they delayed Halloween. I'm not sure. I remember there was a couple of years ago when we had that freak snowstorm
in
October.
No, but last year, I don't believe it was delayed.
Yeah, I'm not sure. That had to be very traumatic.
I remember being here last year, and we did. We had quite a few trick-or-treaters coming in. It seemed like it was nonstop last year.
Yeah, and I think it was, I'm going to guess, it was because it was a school night, and because they said, all right, 7 to 8, or 6 to 7, do your trick-or-treating, and then let's go home. Now, maybe because it's the weekend, and because we have 4 days of no school for the kids, they could kind of stretch out the Halloween experience for them, and we're hoping that part of the Halloween experience is coming here to 28 South Orchard Street and saying hello to us at Trick or Treat TV here at WPAA.
We promise we won't scare you too much.
No, not more than we normally do. All right, I brought something here. This is from CBS News. This is the top 20 Halloween costumes for 2015. They're a little bizarre. A lot of them I don't know. A couple of them make me laugh, but I'll read it and then we'll take it from there. Now, of the top 20 costumes, in at number 20, it's a Bruce Jenner costume for men. Now, what it is, it's a track and field outfit, similar to what normal runners and track and field athletes wear, during competition, but it is similar to the uniform that the now Caitlyn Jenner wore as Bruce Jenner back in the 1976 Olympics in Montreal. But that, anyway, the Bruce Jenner costume is number 20 on the list of the top 20 Halloween costumes for 2015. In at number 19 are characters from the Netflix series Orange is the New Black. I haven't seen it either.
I heard a lot about it.
Yeah, I
gotta go on and check it out.
I have too. I've had friends of mine that that have seen it and in rave about it. My daughter-in-law loves it. I just you know, I'm on Netflix now, and I've of course I went through the first five seasons of Walking Dead, so I'm all caught up now. And I watched House of Cards. I am struggling to get through Sons of Anarchy, which is about the motorcycle gang. I'm three episodes in. I don't, you know, it's not grabbing me like Walter White or Breaking Bad.
I couldn't get into that.
I don't
grab me either.
Yeah. So, but I'm DVRing now that Walking Dead is in season six. I'm DVRing everything.
I might have to check out that Orange Is the New Black because I've heard a lot of people talking about that.
Yeah. Evidently, it's a hit. All right, that is the 19th best costume on our top 20 costumes, Halloween costumes for 2015. In at number 18, and it's somebody we remember, is the character Maleficent. The copy here says the fictitious mother of one of those teen descendants. Maleficent also was a hit movie for Angelina Jolie over a year ago. Now I remember Maleficent as the evil queen in Snow White.
Was it the evil queen?
Yeah, back in 1937, I think in the end of the movie, I hope it's not a spoiler alert from 1937, but she turned into a dragon and then fought the handsome prince, and then Maleficent was no more. But anyway, the character Maleficent in at number 18 for the top 20 Halloween costumes for 2015. In at number 17, costumes from the motion picture Disney's Descendants. Now, the film is about four teenage children of famous Disney princesses and villains. I did not know that until I looked this up. You?
No.
You didn't? Alan, did you know about that? So, no. So, we're unanimous here. We should ask if the kids come back. We'll ask if they do that. But costumes from Disney's Descendants is the 17th most popular costume on the CBS Top 20 Halloween Costumes for 2015. In at number 16, and this is one I think, Tom, that is near to both of our hearts here. This is a Deflategate. It is a Deflategate costume.
A deflated football?
Yes, and what it is, it's a giant football that you wear, and it's a football-shaped costume. And now that kind of Deflategate is now been kind of put on the back burner.
Did I hear that, though, again, that decision is being appealed again?
It's being appealed again, but from what I understand, they won't go to court again until February, and of course by that time the Super Bowl will be over. We just saw someone in the parking lot here that grabbed her candy and ran. That's the shot you see on your screen now of where we are at 28 South Orchard Street, and you could come down here and get some healthy but delicious trick or treat treats here, and come up in the studio and talk to Tommy and I and talk a little bit about Halloween. If nothing else, if they're afraid of us, it's they should come up just to keep warm, I would think.
Yeah, it's nice and warm in the studio.
It's getting colder and colder out there, yeah.
Deflategate.
Yeah, costume number 16, so crazy. All right, in at number 15, a Netflix and chill costume for couples. And what it is, it's just a T-shirt with the Netflix logo and one with the Chill logo. I don't even know what Chill is, but evidently it's another some sort of...
movie channel?
I think so, yeah. Something like that. But that is the 15th most popular costume for the for 2015. Now, in at number 14 is a costume called D's Nuts. And D's Nuts, all right, Al, so you've heard of that. D's Nuts for President. It's an acorn costume. You are familiar with it, all right?
I would vote for him if he
All right. Alan says he would vote for it. D's Nuts for President. It's an acorn costume, and it actually was inspired. Now, I don't remember this, but it was inspired by the 15-year-old boy who registered in Iowa as an inspiring presidential candidate dressed as an acorn running as an independent. He called himself D's Nuts. Evidently, it became some sort of cultural icon. And
did it have a video and did it go viral?
Let me get
I just wondering if they had a video of it and maybe it went viral.
It didn't go it went viral, but there was no video. The guy just, the 15-year-old just submitted paperwork that just asked for his name, but didn't ask for age.
Oh, really? Oh, that's right. You have to be 35, I think.
35, yeah.
The presidential form doesn't ask for age. It just asks for your name and your address. So he just put his name and address on there, and he was registered as a candidate. Just that he can be a candidate all the way up to the finals. So he's technically out now because he's technically underage.
Yeah.
Now, he's nuts. I like that.
Now he did it for this election or was
for this election.
Oh, for this election. Oh, okay. All right. So it's a recent phenomenon.
It was all
so.
A joke.
So yeah.
I like that.
Well, there are some people that think the four debates we've seen so far, the Republican and Democratic are a joke. I don't want to get too political here, but are a joke. All right. We just had a vote for the candidate that looks like Larry David. I'll say here, but anyway, that is the 14th most popular costume.
That's funny. I like that.
Yeah, YouTube sensation and a model candidate for all. D's Nuts.
I do not see any trick or treaters in the area.
I don't either. Boy, I don't even see any cars here. So. But we will effort on here, and I'm sure we'll get some as the as we get into the evening. All right, that was number 14. Again, reviewing from 20 to 14, a Bruce Jenner tracksuit. Characters from the Netflix series Orange is the New Black. Maleficent, the mother of one of the teen descendants. Costumes from Disney's Descendants. Deflategate. A Netflix and chill costume for couples, and at number 14, D's Nuts for President. Now, the 13th most popular costume, and I'm thinking this is something that we'll probably see more and more of as we get closer and closer to December 17th, and that is Star Wars The Force Awakens. Now, and Alan, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think December 17th is when that movie comes out. I've been seeing that. I've been seeing articles about it. I think even our own holiday cinema in Wallingford is putting in new seats or making new theaters or getting ready for the big event on December 17th for the new Star Wars, The Force Awakens. They had a movie trailer of it during the Monday Night Football game. I don't think it was this past one, but it was a week ago. But evidently, it was a big hit. So, and the, you know, that segment of the population that's in the Star Wars is just going crazy. So, in at number 13 for the top rated costume for the year 2015 is Star Wars, The Force Awakens. Now, at number 12, and in keeping with the Star Wars theme, is the Star Wars costume. Anything Star Wars. The example that they had for this one was Yoda. Yep. And they actually had one of a dog that was had a Yoda costume. So, and it looks good. And it's nice to know that Yoda, who I'm going to say made his original debut, and was it The Empire Strikes Back? Right, the third installment of the original Star Wars.
It's been so long since I've seen the Star Wars movies, I can't recall.
Yeah, yeah.
I think you may be right. I think it's Empire Strikes Back.
I haven't seen the Star Wars movie since the original one with Alec Guinness, but and that I know that was back in 1977. All right, that is the 12th most popular costume. Moving on to number 11, and this I guess is another show. It's from Suicide Squad, and it's based on actor Jared Leto's Joker character.
Never heard of it. Suicide Squad?
Suicide Squad, it's called. And Jared Jared Leto, maybe it's pronounced. I remember him because he won the Best Supporting Actor for the Dallas Buyers Club in a movie with Matthew McConaughey. Best Actor. An awesome movie. And Jared Leto's character was awesome in it. But anyway, it's his Joker character from Suicide Squad is the 11th most popular costume for the year 2015. So now we get down to the top 10. And
it can be like David Letterman.
Yes. Now, in at number 10, and I think you kind of figured, probably the next two you probably thought was coming. In at number 10, it's an outfit called Sexy Trump.
Donald Trump.
It's Sexy Trump costume. It is available at Yandy.com. It's, and they say it's recommended for women, but it has a coat, a tie, a hat, and of course, a huge wig.
I was going to say, you got to have the wig.
Yep. That is in at number 10. And, of course, following that at number 9 is Donald Trump himself, the Donald. So not only is he getting all the exposure because of the campaign, he's also becoming a very popular Halloween costume. Not the first time, because I do remember a long time ago, it was I think it was in 2008. It was shortly before the Obama-McCain election in 2008. But there were a lot of Barack Obama masks.
Yeah, I remember seeing the Obama
coming
mask
around. Yeah, they were they were very popular. So and it worked for then Senator Obama. So maybe it'll work for the Donald with the sexy Trump and the Donald Trump himself. Yep. Yep, we just have, what do we have? What did somebody say? We have 1 year and 3 days to think about it till Election Day. All right, that is the 9th most popular costume for 2015. Once again, we're here at WPAA, Trick or Treat TV. Our favorite haunt on Halloween night for our second year as we're up here. We have people giving out healthy and delicious treats to our Halloween trick-or-treaters here at 28 South Orchard Street. And if they want to come up, we encourage them to come up and say hello to us and get on TV. And their friends can see them.
Give out that link again.
Yes, for this the is, HD. Yep. They could watch live on HD. Maybe they're in another town. Can't get it if they don't have Frontier. Can't get it in this town, but they could watch live HT by going to WPAA.TV, click on Watch TV, then click the Click Here feature, and then they're showing it right on the screen now. You click on the Click Here, and you will see Tom and I in our gory best here in delightful high definition HD TV, so which is a new feature here at WPAA TV. You know, your town, your station, your equipment, and it's the latest in equipment. And you can come down and you can make television along with us here.
We do have some tremendous new equipment here.
Yes, state of the art. It's very nice. All right, so we're going over the top 20 Halloween costumes for 2015. This is from CBS News. We started the top 10. There is a shot of our street once again. Now this is the number 8 costume. And this is a Bad Blood costume based on Taylor Swift's music video. Now, I know who Taylor Swift is.
Yeah.
I'm not familiar with the
video,
so it's a but evidently it's a very popular video, and I guess some of the costumes that are worn in that video are very popular.
I'll have to check it out when I go home. I'll have to look up the video.
So we'll see that. This is another one in this probably is like D's Nuts is a viral video sensation, but it's the and I'll go with number 7 and number 6, the pizza rat and the sexy pizza rat. Again, it was on a site called Yandy, YNDY.com. Pizza Rat is a viral video star, and I didn't write this down in doing research on this, but I did see it had something to do with a rat going into a pizza parlor and coming out with a couple of slices of cheese and just eating a couple slices of pizza and just eating them like you or I would if we, you know, went out of a pizza parlor. But evidently it's become a viral video sensation, and now is on the top 20 list for costumes for 2015. All right, we'll go to the top 5, and a few of these I'm starting to become familiar with. Number 5, we talked about Bruce Jenner, so...
Now we have Caitlyn.
Caitlyn, you knew it was only a matter of time that Bruce Jenner is the 20th most popular costume. The 5th most popular costume is Caitlyn Jenner. And Tommy, as we talk here, I think we have
some trick-or-treaters coming up.
I'm hearing footsteps coming up. We have a canine here! We have a very nice canine.
I like the jersey.
Yeah, it's a very vicious-looking canine.
I like the jersey.
I'm not sure. But come have a see. A very, very nice jersey.
Fellow Bruins fan, way to go.
Yeah,
here.
This is the...
come on over here. You can sit down in here. Get up there.
Very nice. If we can maybe get a wide shot. There we go. What is the dog's name, sir?
Maggie.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Now, does the dog like public access? She does. Oh, okay.
She does.
Okay. So, bite him first.
So. Maggie. She goes, I like
you. Well,
come on, baby.
Have a seat, please. And let me get Maggie. Do you want to say your name?
Hey, Magamai.
Does she speak?
She's pretty quiet.
I definitely like the attire.
And your name?
Donna McMahon.
Donna
McMahon.
McMahon.
And you are?
Dan McMahon.
Dan McMahon. Now have a seat, Dan.
You've seen while you're walking around.
Now we will assume that Maggie is studio broken.
Oh yes.
All right. Because we're not.
Yeah, she's very good.
So have you been out? Two questions first, because Tom and I were talking about this before. We haven't seen that many trick-or-treaters. Is it because it's Saturday night?
Yeah, I know usually right around my neighborhood we get like later kids come out, yeah.
Okay.
I know it's that every year it gets to be later and later. Usually older kids come out later.
Although, like we said earlier, though, last year we were here, we had quite a few kids come through last year.
Yes, yeah, we were actually walking our grandkids around last year, and there was a lot more kids. There's not too much out.
Do you think because it's Saturday, or?
Could be.
I think, unfortunately, you know, with times and stuff, people are a little bit wary of it. So I think it's more parties and family gatherings and stuff like that.
So you think maybe for safety's sake?
Safety,
so,
you got
Dan,
it.
Dan, you agree?
Yep.
You agree?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
More parties, Halloween parties.
Yeah.
Than going out.
Now, I have to ask, why the Bruins?
Go Bruins!
He's a big Bruins fan. Mm-hmm.
Redskin fan.
Maggie Mann has no choice.
I got a Redskin shirt for her, too.
Now, what kind of dog is this?
She's a Rottweiler.
Okay. Now Rottweilers get a lot of bad press.
Yes, they
right?
do.
What's the biggest? And my sister has a Rottweiler.
Mm-hmm.
So as a matter of fact, the last Rottweiler we had here. No, I'm only kidding.
It's all in the training. It's all in the training. It's all in the training.
What's the biggest misconception? Although you may have answered it, but what's the biggest misconception about Rottweilers?
People are scared. They think that they're just going to attack them or so, but. She's a love bug. She loves people.
Muscles on her.
Yep.
How old is Maggie?
She is with three,
five.
Right?
Five?
Oh, she'll be five.
Five, yes, yep.
And how much does she eat? Does she...
Yeah, we've actually had to cut her down a few times. We take her to the doctors, and they're like, okay, it's time to back off a little bit. But yeah, no, she does. She has her hard food in the morning and her half a can of soft food and then half a can again at night.
Okay. Now, you're from Wallingford.
Oh, yes.
Have you taken her down to the new animal park?
My daughter actually was just telling us about that. So my husband will definitely get her down there.
Good.
Yeah, she's very friendly.
And she socializes with other dogs.
Yes.
Well,
yep.
Have I got a golden retriever for you, Maggie?
I was going to ask if Maureen walks you down there.
Well, Maureen's been keeping me on a short leash for years, so I'm glad of that. Now,
we're on TV.
Is it true? Well, let's hear this conversation. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's our son from Long Island.
Are you on TV? Call us in, and what's the station?
WPAA. Actually, and if he can hear me, if he's near a computer, if he goes on WPAA.TV and click Watch TV and click here, all the way from Long Island. How come you're not an Islander fan? All the way from Long Island.
Wow.
You could see it. Alan, is that correct?
No kidding.
And Alan is showing what your son could do. So. But go ahead, continue the conversation. Just a few more questions about Maggie. So what interested you in a Rottweiler?
Actually, we weren't exactly looking for another dog. We had lost a dog. She had gotten ill and had passed. And my husband was very distraught about it all. So my daughter decided to go and get us another dog. But she saw her, you know, in the ads, and we went and checked her out. And then
is she a rescue?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yes, she's a rescue.
Yes.
Good.
Yep.
Rescues are the best.
Yes. Yep. And she's had her time. Huh? She had bad knees, she's had two surgeries on her knees. And she does good. She's a champion. She's a love bug. She loves kids. She loves people.
Nice.
Yeah.
Now, when people come to the house, not necessarily trick or treaters, but if anybody knocks on the door, does she bark and alert you?
She'll be right at the door, right behind us. She'll sit tight, but she will definitely be right there.
All right.
So if you weren't home, and Maggie was, and someone came to the house with the intent of maybe taking a few things, she would be.
They wouldn't get through the door.
Good. Best
she's
protection
very,
right
very
there.
Protective, especially with the grandkids at the house, too.
And there you see some more trick-or-treaters here. No, that's okay. Now, one more for me, and please tell me this is true. Is it true that Rottweilers like to eat dolphins? That is a dig.
I don't think she likes fish at all.
All right. Good. Well, nobody does except, and he's a Miami Dolphin fan, so it.
Yeah, she's with Redskins with Daddy too. So.
Oh, okay.
Although I am all Boston except for football.
There you go.
Football,
there
so,
you
okay.
go. Very good.
Well, listen, guys, we want to thank you.
Thank you.
It's very nice to meet you.
Thank you. Have a great one.
You too.
Go Bruins.
Yep.
Thanks, me, Dan. Go Bruins.
Come on, baby.
All right, Maggie. Nice meeting you.
Take care.
We have some more trick-or-treaters coming.
Yeah,
back.
We have some more. Thank you. Yes, come in and sit down here. Most impressive.
Hi, hello there.
Most impressive. How are you?
We're great. My name is Phil.
Okay, have a seat. Ghouls and girls, or girls and guys.
And who's next to you, Phil?
This is my friend Alicia, and this is my friend Andy.
And how's the night been so far?
Oh, it's going great. I finally rounded up all my friends. A bunch of them were going to a party, and they said that they didn't really feel like trick or treating. I'm like, you know, I think that's really lame. And it's trick-or-treating. No,
everyone's
too old
for it now.
And I'm going to go trick-or-treating, gather all my candy, and if they don't give me candy, well, they're going to get tricked. And then I'm going to go cause shenanigans with the other creatures of the night.
Have you seen many trick-or-treaters along your travels? We were just saying that.
There's a bunch of them on this road. The street we started on looked dead, but there's a bunch of lights on, and everyone's enjoying the spirits. You know, it's an amazing holiday. Mm-hmm. Everyone gets to be someone besides
themselves. Now, you are... it's Alice in Wonderland.
I'm a my own version of the Mad Hatter.
Mad Hatter. Oh, yeah. Okay.
I'm a magical security officer from Planet Utopia 6.
Oh, okay. Okay, and the young lady here?
I'm kind of like a female version twist thing of the Joker.
Oh, okay. Okay. Very good. I can't think of the character's name now. Who was the Joker?
Heath Ledger.
He was an amazing actor.
Yeah, he was. He was. And you, young person?
I'm a hobo chic sugar skull.
Hobo chic? Okay.
Look at the kids.
Well, you're doing very good. One more question for me, and now they're starting to come in droves, which is nice. The fact that that Halloween is on a Saturday night, and no school, no work, no nothing tomorrow, does that enhance the pleasure of Halloween being on Saturday night?
100%.
Oh, I got work tomorrow. I got work tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, she'll survive, though.
Oh, hopefully.
All right. We won't ask what you do. Do you want to stay? We have more guests that they could stand by. Behind her, unless you have someplace to go? Do you have other?
Oh, yeah, we got someplace to go. Yep. Have a great evening, though.
Thank you for stopping by.
You guys are awesome. So.
Oh, yeah.
Very, very, very nice. So.
Can somebody open these?
Nice costumes. All right, guys. Come on over and, have a seat on the couch here.
We have a couple of scream masks over there.
Yep. And I'm going to say, is it a Rubik's Cube? I don't know. Okay, and first of all, let's start with two screams. What's your name?
Cesar,
okay. And the individual next to you?
Christian.
Cesar and Christian, okay. And you see yourself on TV, on the monitor. And the young person sitting on the floor, your name?
Connor.
So the C's have it tonight. Connor, Christian, and Cesar. I like that. So tell me how Halloween has been so far. You've been getting some good treats?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, really good.
All right. Are there a lot of people out trick-or-treating? We haven't seen that many as of yet, but are there a lot out there now?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. I asked the other Halloween people here earlier, the other trick-or-treaters, if it was nice having Halloween on a Saturday night. How is that better with your schedule?
Yes.
You don't have school or...
I just care about that I'm part of the building.
For 4 days.
Oh, oops.
We don't have school in 4 days.
So you're out of school for 4 days. So you can go on a sugar bender for two or 3 days now then. Nice. That's good for you.
I'm fascinated by the mask over there. I just noticed the blood dripping down over there. See that, Ed?
Yeah, that's very good. Very, very realistic. So, well, all right, guys. We appreciate you stopping by. What's the favorite part of Halloween for you guys besides coming to see us?
Getting candy.
Getting candy, all right.
And what's your favorite?
And eating candy.
What, do you have a favorite candy?
Kit Kat.
Kit Kat.
Milk Duds and Dots.
Milk Duds and Dots and Kit Kat, all right. Very good. All with ample amounts of sugar, so. All right, guys, we really appreciate you stopping by. Thank you for coming by Trick or Treat TV here at WPAA. Excuse me, young man, let me get your mic here. I don't think they can hear you. What did you say? All right, Connor, we appreciate it.
Thank you.
And I think we have one lonely trick-or-treater with two huge bags of candy here. I don't know if... did you want to come on and say hello? No? All right. He'd rather decline, so...
I like that mask.
That is a very... very nice mask. Actually, kind of scary.
You.
Thank you. All right, guys. We'll see you next year. Well, that was a nice little rush of trick-or-treaters that we had. And you could do, as we often say.
I like Phil's take on the Mad Hatter.
Yeah. Yes.
excuse me, it was very good. They were dressed up very nice.
What do you say, Mad Hatter security guard?
Yes, yes. So, he was good. You know, we were talking about Eric before and talking about Halloween, his favorite. I forgot, and later on I talk about scary movies, time permitting. But I have to give you a plug for Burial Boys.
Burial Boys,
which is
yeah.
kind of a Halloween movie, a movie that I personally thought you should have been nominated for Best Supporting Actor.
And of course, his other movie, Bullets for the Damned.
Yes, yes, which
Dave Burkhart.
Yes, and I hope Dave's not watching because I haven't seen it yet. So I've seen bits and pieces of it, but I haven't seen the whole thing. So, but yeah, Burial Boys.
We still have a few on our costume list.
Yes, we were costume. At the.
I believe we got to.
Caitlyn Jenner was number 5 in a list of the 20 best costumes. In at number 4, and this is one that even I know, is the Minion characters from the motion picture.
Pixar movie, right?
That yeah, yep. Despicable Me.
Yep.
It was called. Minion, and if I'm not mistaken, was it Despicable Me that the song Happy came from? I could be wrong, and
I don't
that
know.
Pharrell song Happy, Alan, if
Pharrell,
you know,
was it?
Pharrell song Happy, was that from Despicable?
I don't know. Despicable. I think there was a movie about penguins too that was called Happy.
Well, that was Happy Feet. I do remember that, but yeah, but
I'll have to research that also.
Anyway. The number 4 rated, or the number 4 in popular costume for 2015 are the Minion characters, and I see them. You know, I was at Quinnipiac yesterday for the standardized patient gig that I have, and yesterday was, they had a costume parade for the students. They dressed up, and they had one kid, and I had forgotten about this, but he was dressed as Ralphie in his pajamas, the bunny pajamas. And what made it funny was the kid was like 6'5". So wearing this huge costume with the ears sticking out, he looked like he was 10 feet tall. But it was awesome. But there were a couple of Minions running around Quinnipiac University yesterday. So, okay, our top 3 costumes for 2015. I don't know any of them. But at number 3 is Harley Quinn, who is
from Batman.
Well, my copy here has Harley Quinn, female supervillain from Suicide Squad. But was she, if she was in Batman?
It's a Batman character, too.
She is.
Animated series.
Oh, yeah. She is? Oh, okay. Okay, Harley Quinn. In at number 2 are the rest of the Suicide Squad characters.
Hmm.
And the number 1 costume for the year 2015, again, this is according
to... Wait, drum roll.
This is according to CBS News. Are characters from the Disney Pixar movie Inside Out? Now, I didn't see this movie. I heard a lot about it. But evidently, the characters are the emotions that are at play within us. Anger, disgust, a lot of the feelings we have when we watch the Jets and the Dolphins, usually. You know, anger, disgust.
That.
Fear, joy, and I guess with this movie, each emotion was a character. I think Sandra Bullock was one of the voices too. I remember hearing that. So, but anyway, the characters from the Disney movie Inside Out, the number 1 costume for the top 20 Halloween costumes for the year 2015. Once again, you're watching WPAA special Trick-or-Treat TV with
Trick-or-Treat TV.
Talking with Tom and Ed McCarver here.
I don't know how this compares to must-see TV, but
yes. So, well, we hope it does. I hope my wife is watching, and I know Riley's watching. If he's not barking at some of the trick-or-treaters, what a nice dog Maggie was.
Yes.
The Boston Bruins dog, a Rottweiler, and it was nice to talk to her. You know, in what the woman was telling us, Mrs. McMahon was telling us, and my sister will verify this because she has 2 Rottweilers, as, you know, they get a lot of bad press.
And the same thing with the pit bulls.
Yes,
though.
Yes, exactly.
I agree.
You know, when you see a pit bull, you automatically think the worst, that that you're going to lose a limb, that they're going to be aggressive, and it's that really is not the case. Certainly wasn't the case with Maggie, who was running around here and was making herself at home. So she was a very nice dog, a nice companion. Loves kids, and then as the woman mentioned, when she leaves the house, and if Maggie comes home, if Maggie's home alone, and someone is intending on robbing the house, you know, it won't go past Maggie, becomes vicious. So, yeah. Which is good.
So, great security feature, a nice dog. Like we said.
Yeah, not like Riley, you know, a golden retriever. We were talking, Riley would a perpetrator would come into the house and Riley would say, hey, don't forget the silverware in the other room. But that's how golden retrievers are.
Can we get another shot of outside, Alan?
We thought we heard some voices outside.
See what's going on outside?
Unless it was the voices in our heads. But there's a group of, in the lower right-hand portion of the screen, a group of trick-or-treaters. Now, let's see if we can keep that shot for a moment. Let's see if they will wend their way upstairs or head off. All right, it looks like they're coming upstairs. All right, so. All right, it looks like a good group of trick-or-treaters. So they will be on screen here very, very shortly. You'll see them on television or on HD at WPAA.TV. It's kind of like Christmas morning here, and I'm scurrying upstairs. Yeah. It's so exciting. Welcome. Look at you. Come on in.
I see we have the Hulk.
Look at. All right. Let's.
We have the Hulk.
All right. Come in and get comfortable. Sit down.
Mixie and Dad, you have to come over here. I can see you.
All right, and now, I know your fictional name is Hulk, but what's your real name?
Daniel.
Okay.
And his real name is Bruce Banner.
Okay. And the young lady in the middle, your character?
Monster Heidel. Caddy Nori, that's her name.
Okay, and your real name?
Kaylin.
Kaylin, okay,
very good girl.
And you are I'm starting to watch The Walking Dead, and it maybe seeing you. You're not from The Walking Dead.
Nope.
Oh, sorry. All right, where you're from? Or what's your name and where you're from?
I'm Haley, and I'm Eyeless Jack.
A creepy pasta.
Okay, your character is
Eyeless Jack.
Oh, okay.
Eyeless Jack.
Cool. But they're all very, very authentic. Well, give us the report card on.
We don't know the.
The report card. Halloween so far, has it been successful?
Yeah, we already got pieces of candy, but I dumped mine in my bag. A ham.
Okay.
Sit.
All right, and then how's the Halloween been for you so far?
Good.
How long did it take you to put on that costume? It's a very elaborate costume.
Mine?
Not yours.
Like 2 minutes.
2 minutes?
Mine was wasn't a long time.
Oh, okay. And how about you, Miss Eyeless? So how long did it take to put that costume on?
Like 12 minutes.
I can see him.
Okay. You guys see yourself? That's an awesome picture on TV. All right, what's your favorite part of Halloween besides appearing with these two dead guys up here? So, what's the best part of Halloween?
Dead. I'm not dead, but the part of I don't know.
Okay, and Eyeless, what's your favorite part of Halloween?
Dressing up.
Wait, my favorite part is getting candy and dressing up.
Oh, all right. How much of the candy have you eaten already?
Zero.
Oh, okay. All right. Now, all right. Do you want to leave? Do the adults want to come on?
Yeah.
Okay. No, that's all right. They don't have to.
I want to see you go.
Well, all right, guys. We want to thank you for
for trick-or-treating. Have fun. Good luck to you guys.
Thank you.
Yes.
All right.
Thank you.
Good job, guys. So.
I think we have a future television host.
Yes, I have a feeling that after
maybe the next Ed McCarver.
Yes, so. Well, they certainly weren't shy. They were very very
lively boys.
Yeah, good kids. I thought maybe they had started to consume some of their candy already, but the Hulk says that wasn't the case. But that was good. So it's nice that they're maybe not as many as we've had.
All right, let me give you a hand.
Yeah, all right, thank you. I need a manicure. I think it hasn't been as many as last year, but it certainly has been a lively bunch that came in. So that's good. So as we regroup here, the calm between the storms here. So we went through the costumes. We did the candy. Once again, the top candy in Connecticut is your favorite, Tom, Reese's peanut butter cups.
Speaking of Reese's, you know what I saw last night? I've never thought of doing this. I happened to be over at Holy Trinity playing bingo last night.
Uh-huh.
And somebody walked around serving peanut butter cups on a pretzel stick.
Really?
Yeah.
I had never heard of that. Did you try one?
Yeah.
Was it good?
First time I've ever seen that, but yeah, it was pretty interesting.
Interesting, yeah. Yeah, that sounds good.
A little thin pretzel stick.
Reese's peanut butter cup on a pretzel stick.
Yeah.
Huh. We'll have to consider that. We have the most popular candy by state, and some of these candies I never heard of. For example, in Arizona, the most popular candy is something called Toblerone.
Toblerone, yeah. You don't remember Toblerone?
Toblerone.
You don't remember that?
I really don't.
Used to be one of the big prizes on Wheel of Fortune.
Really?
The big Toblerone chalk, yeah.
It's chocolate?
Yeah.
I did not know that. What else? All right, those I have heard of.
I think it's still around here, too. I think you can find it around here.
Louisiana. The top candy is something called Swedish fish.
Yep, I've had those.
You've had Swedish fish?
Alan, he does not know what Swedish fish are.
No.
I'm gonna have to
I'm
get
65
him a
years old. I've never had Swedish fish.
I'm gonna have
fish
to get him a bag now.
Are they good?
Yeah.
Swedish fish. Is it chocolate?
No.
It's not those Swedish things like see like cocktail parties.
They're,
or the
no, they're gummies.
Oh, gummies!
Yeah,
gummies! Oh.
I cannot believe you have not had Swedish fish.
I'm
gonna have to go out and get him some now, Alan.
I haven't. Actually, I was looking at the candy for Utah, which I know is something that you not only have eaten, but you live and breed nerds.
Yep.
And that goes for Alan too. And there was one. Well, another one that might go actually could go for me too. Washington State. The most popular candy is Airheads.
Yep, I've had those.
Yep. All right, tell me if you've had this one. Both South Dakota and Wisconsin, Laffy Taffy?
Yep.
Laffy Taffy?
Yep, that's around.
Is it like, as a kid, I remember Bonomo's Turkish Taffy. Is it the same thing?
How would you describe Laffy Taffy? It's different flavors. It is a taffy.
It's just really chewy.
Yeah, it's really chewy.
It's the same thing. It's just
like the old Bonomo's Turkish Taffy? That
Willy Wonka Laffy Taffys are thicker.
Yeah.
Willy Wonka Laffy.
You had salt water taffy?
Yeah.
Yeah, same thing.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Laffy Taffy, okay.
Yeah.
So if you're in South Dakota or if you are in Wisconsin, Laffy Taffy is your most popular candy. The rest are all,
Alaska Snickers, Arkansas Skittles, California's Lifesavers. Our nation's capital is Twix. Delaware is Three Musketeers. What's a pixie stick?
Those sticks with the powdered sugar in them.
Oh, okay.
Like powdered sugar.
If you're in Georgia, that's the number one candy. Hawaii, the 100 grand bar.
Yeah.
It's probably how much it costs out in Hawaii.
Are those still around? I don't see those much anymore, but I do remember that was being around.
The 100?
The 100
okay.
grand, right. Yeah.
Idaho Butterfinger, Iowa Twix, Illinois Snickers, Maine Starburst, Maryland Almond Joy. We said Massachusetts was Starburst. Mississippi and Missouri, Hershey's Kisses, Montana Kit Kat, North Carolina Butterfinger, Nevada, which I will be going back to in a couple of weeks with Drew. We're going out to our favorite city, Las Vegas. Jolly Rancher is the official. And now I do remember Jolly Ranchers.
Yeah, they're still around.
Yeah, yeah. And now, I don't know if this is typical for West Virginia or not, but the most popular candy in West Virginia is Oreos cookies. So evidently, when they did the survey, they but Oreos cookies is the number one in West Virginia. Wyoming likes the candy corn. Vermont has the Almond Joy. Texas and Tennessee has the candy corn, as does South Carolina, as does Oregon. And I think New York has Sweet Tarts. Ohio has Milky Way. New Jersey, the Sour Patch Kids.
Sour Patch
So, not sure if I would like that. So that about covers Colorado, the Milky Way. I think I got them all. So anyway, that is the interesting. And as I say, I first heard about this on Chaz and AJ this week. So I said, well, let me do some research, and maybe it's something we could use here. Again, we are at WPAA. Trick or Treat TV. We are approaching the bottom of the hour, going on 7:30. But this is kind of fun. This is kind of fun. We kind of wish maybe there were more kids, but candy for us.
Gee, we made it through the whole.
Yeah, yeah. So we've got 3 minutes left. I did have one more thing. The highest grossing horror movies of all time.
Halloween?
Was not on there.
Ooh.
But the number three are actually movies that we both have seen. Because there were some of the lists, like I Scream 3, Sleepy Hollow, Scream 2, Scream 4. I've never saw. The Blair Witch Project I saw, and that came in at number 5. But do you want it to, and I had Maureen do this, because actually the three of these movies I saw with her. Do you want to take a guess as to what the three highest grossing horror movies were of
Friday
all time?
Friday the
13th? Nope. No Jason, no Freddy. No slash and stab type movies.
I have no clue then.
All right. We've only got 3 minutes, so let me do a quick. Okay. In at number three, grossing $232.9 million from 1973, The Exorcist. Linda Blair and Ellen Burstyn. And I remember when that came out. I mean, I was terrified. I remember I said to Maureen.
Pea soup after that.
Yep, yeah. I said to Maureen, please hold me after the movie. But as usual, she wouldn't. Yeah. So, but The Exorcist, 1973. In at number two, $260 million from 1975. I'll give you a clue. Steven Spielberg.
Jaws,
you got it. Jaws, yep. The number two rated movie, $260 million. Now, this final movie, and this is the top highest grossing movie in this genre, the horror genre, made $293.5 million. It is from 1999, as you get one last shot of the scene out here. I had actually forgotten about this movie, but if it's from 1999, I'll let you guess, and if you want to guess first, if not, I'll give you a clue.
Poltergeist?
Nope. Nope. I'm pretty sure you've seen it. Bruce Willis was in it.
I have no clue.
There's a very famous line in it. And the line is, I see blank people.
Oh, I see dead people.
Yes. The Sixth Sense.
Sixth Sense.
The Sixth Sense. It was that little boy, Haley Joel Osment.
Oh, wow.
Who said, I saw dead people. And that was the, you know, against Jaws, against The Exorcist, Blair Witch, Saw 3, Scream 2, all the Wes Craven wow. stuff, Sleepy Hollow. But the number one horror movie, the highest grossing horror movie of all time, believe it or not, and I didn't believe it, was The Sixth Sense
wow.
With Bruce Willis and Haley wow. Joel Osment, an awesome movie.
I don't know. Just, how are we doing on time, Alan?
What time are you guys on to?
I thought Sue said we had 3 minutes.
3 minutes, 7:30.
19:31 right now.
So I think in the 30 seconds we have left.
Want to thank everybody for joining us.
And we'll see you next year. And we'll see you next month on Talking with Tom.
Happy Halloween.
Bye-bye now. That still was fun.